the fire is...
Hey, look, I don't know. Maybe it's emergency head shrinking. Stick with me, Sonny. This is decision time.
I want to hang on to our partnership, Luke. It means a lot to me.
You want to hang on to it enough to tell Sculley to kiss off? Because I won't deal with it, man. Not only do I choose my own partners, I'm not going to bring my wife and my baby back into a situation with the firebombing and the shootings and the mob muscle.
Unfortunately, like it or not, after the no-name, you're in the mix.
I won't deal with Sculley, man. He does not get a piece of my action, and that ain't open for debate.
The problem is, he's already taken a stand. He can't back off now without losing face.
Well, then I know what my next order of business is. How about you?
Well, you know, there is no choice. I gotta crack Frank's business all on my own. I mean, I owe a lot to Joe, but not that. And I owe a lot to you for living up to our deal. Joe hasn't respected that.
Well, you know, like I told you, if you decide to go toe-to-toe with Joe, I'll stand right there with you.
Appreciate that.
You also know that that would mean war, and that we would fight it the old-fashioned way, meaning people would get killed.
Yeah, I don't want that.
Neither do I.
Well, we gotta figure out another way.
Keep talking.
Well, I mean, I don't know. We're two smart, motivated, experienced guys. There's two of us against one of Joe. We gotta figure out a way to just flat-out think of it.
See? Man, in the spirit of this new nonviolent organization that you head, I like that.
Good, good. It's gonna be a little dangerous for a while.
Yeah, no, I figure that.
So where is Laura and Leslie to do while we make this happen?
Well, this thing is under control. Well, it's bad enough having Lucky in town. I gotta leave my wife and my baby where they are.
I don't envy you having to tell her.
Oh, man. I haven't even told her about Donnelly yet. I may as well give her all the good news at once. It's going to be ugly, man. It's going to be ugly. You know, dodging bullets is a lot easier than dodging Laura. I'm telling her, she's mad as hell. I guess she's got good reason to be. I've got to be able to tell her that this thing is going to be over soon. Fast.
You know, I know. Well, at least we have the beginnings of a plan. So you tell Laura. I'll deal with Joe.
Oh.
Stall.
Be careful. He's gonna expect trouble.
I can deal with it.
What else?
Brenda, she was all over me about questions, you know, about you, Joe at the no name, and Sean's getting shot.
Can you trust her to keep her mouth shut? Sonny, can you?
Yeah, I'm made out for, she'll be cool.
Okay, well, hold down the fort. I gotta tie up some loose ends in the office, then I gotta go to Ruby's. Tell Lucky we're leaving for Beecher's Corners in the morning. By the way, you never heard that. No Beecher's Corners. Never heard that, right?
Got it. When are you heading out?
First thing tomorrow.
Don't forget, Mary Mays. Get here tomorrow.
No, I won't miss that. Let's see. Hey. Wait, what was up with Lucy Combs?
Oh, her doctor got beefed. She was packing a cellular phone. He made a call, got a little unhinged. Bad news, I guess.
Huh. Okay. Listen, I'm not going to be here tomorrow. Keep an eye on things. I'll be back by dark.
Sure.
Okay.
Hi. Listen, I'm going to start with the easy stuff.
Okay.
Ned got back from his visit with Lois's parents with no missing body parts. Looks like they're gonna make it work.
Well, considering Carmine and Gloria were probably loaded for bear, that's an accomplishment. Good news.
Yeah, well, can you believe they're getting ready to go have dinner up at the Quartermains? I just came from home and Lois was desperately trying to figure out what she's going to wear. So I think if she survives tonight, they're home free.
My money is on Lois. Hell, she's gotta make it happen. As much as Ned doesn't deserve her, L&B is gonna go down to tubes if they don't get it straight.
Yeah.
Right.
So what's the situation with Luke?
Under control.
Sonny, I need more than that.
I know that, and I plan to tell you.
We've got our reservations tangled tomorrow night.
Make it quick.
Well, the Mary May Ward gig is booked solid, and Edward Quartermain just called demanding a table.
Well, add a table somewhere. Make it happen.
Right. No problem.
I'm going to tell you some things that are extremely confidential. I mean, I know you're always asking me to share things with you, so here it goes, but this has to come with the guarantee that it goes no further.
Got it.
I mean, no one, not Lois, because there could be a major fallout if this leaks.
Sonny, I understand. I'm capable of keeping my mouth shut.
Okay. I just told you the short version of the Joe Sculley story. I'll fill in the blanks. When I was a kid, Joe was on the fast track up in this organization that parallels Frank Smith's. When I needed direction, he took me in, showed me the ropes, introduced me to some guys who could get me started. So the business I started in was Joe's business.
I understand.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
Right. Joe was good to me. Very, very good. And I owe him, not just on a personal level, but in business. I'll never forget him. I mean, he was the guy who arranged for me to take over at the Paradise. Harry was retiring, and that's how I started here in Port Charles. Okay, anyway, fast forward to 1995. Joe is now running the New York organization. He comes up here to congratulate me, wish me good luck. Right. But he also wants a cut of the club.
No.
10% for protection. It's a shakedown, but unfortunately, it's pretty standard procedure.
So that's why Luke met him at the Nunnane?
Right.
And that's why Luke is so angry about Joe.
Luke doesn't want Joe involved with any part of the club.
Oh, my. And what about L&B, Sonny? Does he want a piece of L&B?
No. L&B has nothing to do with this problem. All right? It's just the club.
What are you going to do?
I told him I'm not interested. He's not pleased. But I will handle it peacefully, with smarts. Nobody.
Can you?
Well, you know, Luke and I are, we're working on this. You know, but it's going to take a little bit of time. That's why I need you to stay cool until this is completely over. I mean, last thing I need is for you to get involved. So, can you trust me? Can you accept that what I'm telling you is the truth? And stay out of it. I knew his wife and kids. I was practically a member of his own family. But Joe is tough. And sentiment takes you only so far. It's about time he understands who I am and what my boundaries are.
I just wish that it didn't sound so dangerous.
I'll be fine. And so will Luke. You know, I just have to... I gotta handle this carefully, with respect. And you are not in danger. I would not do that to you. All we have to do is stay cool. There's nothing to worry about.
I want to believe you so bad.
But do you?
Yes. I believe you.
That's my girl.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
What can I do to help? I mean, besides keep this between us, which of course I will do.
Go on, make it nice with Joe. He thinks you're the cat's meow. Bet you're out of the loop. Let's let him keep thinking that.
Okay, I can do that. Act dumb.
I know it's a lot of effort, but you can do a good job.
Are you going to tell Luke that you told me about this?
Sure. We have no secrets.
Okay, I won't bring it up with him, but just in case he does, I'll know where I stand.
Okay.
And what about Stone?
I will take care of Stone. I'll let you know when and what I tell him.
communication is the name of the game. Isn't that what you keep telling me?
Yeah. I don't like what you're telling me. Mm-hmm. At all. But I'm really glad that you're trusting me enough to talk to me about this. It makes me feel really good about us.